Hello everyone, how are you all? Good to see that you people have received emails from Infosys and you people are getting ready for the Infosys Drive. I'm Mohit Jain, your host, your dost, and as always in the ghost mode from MJ's Maths and Stats or MJ Magic Studio to you. Today in this session we would be discussing about Infosys online assessment, one of the group that is puzzle group actual question asked on 16th May 2021. Actually, they ask four questions in the puzzle segment, which lasts for 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, you need to solve four mathematical or alphanumerical or alphabetical puzzle. Fine. The two questions will be of 2 marks each. And the other two would be of 3 marks each, that accounts to 10 marks, and that also we need to do in 10 minutes. So I'll give you ample time. I'll give you time to solve. Try to solve it yourself and then look out for the solution. So let's start now. Okay, I'll give you an ample time to solve this. Let's have the option. We are looking out for what number should be placed in this question mark position. And the four options given are 217, 115, 277, and 145. And your 1 minute timer starts now. So hopefully you must have got the answer by now, isn't it? In these kind of puzzles, it is always given that there is some relationship with these four number, outer number with the inner one. The same relationship exists with these outer four number and the inner one. And the based on that particular relation, we need to identify the missing number in the third diagram. So very often it's find that by adding or by subtracting or by multiplying these four number by itself or in pair, we often get this middle number. So here what I've tried, 15 into 5, 75, not matching 75 plus 27 or minus 27, not 136. So I tried with squaring the number and then it was actually fitting in. 15 and 5, difference is 10. And here 9 and 3, difference is 6. Now 10 is square is 100 and 6 is square is 36 and it fits in. 100 plus 36 is 136. Now let me check whether it fits in here or not. 44 minus 21 is 23 and 23 is square is 529. 8 minus 3 is 5. And 5 is square is 25. Now 529 plus 25 is 554 and that also matches with here. That means here also our question mark should be 25 minus 11, that is 14 is square. 14 is square is 196 plus 12 minus 3 is 9 and 9 is square is 81. 7, 8, 16, 7, 2. 277 and that fits in option C. Okay, your timer will start, but before that the four options are 1, 0, 2 or 3 and your time starts now. Okay, in these kind of question where we have only single grid and few numbers in columns and row, let me make this as x. What we try to identify is either some equation which fits in row wise or some equation which fits in column wise. So I'm trying to fit an equation column wise because here I can see like 22, 23, 1, 2. So if I add these two, 22 plus 1, 23, but this is 20, or let me add these two, 24 minus 1. Okay, so 22 plus 2 minus 1 is 23. Okay, so 40 plus 5 is 45 minus 2 is 43. That here also fits in. So similarly, in the second column also, this equation should fit in. 30 plus 3 minus x should be equals to 32. This is 33. Therefore, x is equals to 33 minus 32. That is 1. And option A fits in. It's always advisable in these kind of grid, wherever we have got only single grid, try to frame an equation row wise or column wise and fit in with all. Check it with all, and very easily we can find the answer. Okay, before the timer starts, the options here are 28, 30, 29, 27. Let's do it. Okay, as it is always suggested in these kind of question, we should always go and try and for the equation, either row wise or column wise. Here the missing question mark is here, and in first column and second column, small numbers are given compared to third column. So let me go with row wise. 16, 4 and 1, 1 into 4, no one here. Let me square it. 1, 16, but 1 plus 16 is not 16, neither 16 minus 1 is 16. Let me go and check with the second row. 3 square is 9, 5 square is 25. Now 9 plus 25 is 34. 1 plus 16 is 17, but here we have 1 less than their addition. So can I say if this is A, this is B and this is C, I am getting this equation, C equals to A square plus B square minus 1. Let me check with the third row. 4 square is 16, 7 square is 49, that is 65. 65 minus 1 is 64, bingo, it fits in. That means here the question mark C should be equals to 2 square plus 5 square is 25 minus 1. 29 minus 1 is 28, and that features in option A. Okay, before the timer starts, the option for this one are 14, 26, 24 and 10. And here your timer starts. Okay, again a single grid, and as we know the drill, either you go row wise or column wise to fit in the equation. Here we can see that in columns, the top three layers, we have small numbers and at the bottom is like big numbers. So I'll go column wise and try to identify. 654 multiply, if I multiply these two, 6 into 5 is 30, and bingo, we are getting it. If this is A, B, C, D, then D is equals to A into B plus C. 6 into 5 plus 4 is 34. 3 into 7 is 21 plus 3 is 24. So last column value of D would be 4 into 6 plus 2. 24 plus 2 is 26, and that fits in option B. Okay, before the timer starts, the options are 75, 70, 77, 80. What should feature at this point? And your time begins now. Yes, this particular grid follows the simplest of the rule in the grid solution. Either you go in for the multiplication column wise or row wise. Here I'll start up with column because these numbers are big, fair enough. And the first basic hit, we always do it. Let's square it and add up, and that fits in. Here D is equals to A square plus B square plus C square. 25 plus 4, 29 plus 1 is 30. 9 plus 16, 25 plus 25 is 50. So here the value of D would be 7 is square, 49 plus 1 is square is 1, and 5 square is 25. That is 75, and it fits in option A. 75 is the missing number. Okay, here the four numbers are 2, 7, 5, 4. 4, 3, 8, 8, 6, and this is 2 question mark which we are looking out for, 5, 8. So this is 2, 7, 5, 4, 4, 3, 8, 6, and this is 2x 5, 8, and the four options which we have is 9, 6, 7, 8, and your time starts now. This is a special kind of a grid question. These four number 2754 should be leading to 4386, and this may lead us to 2x58, because as we have done one more puzzle here, the central value is not given, so we need to find the link with these four numbers, which might get linked with these four numbers and which might get linked with these four numbers. So simple link I'm trying to develop: 2 plus 7 plus 5 plus 4, 12 plus 6 is 18. So first block is 18 if I add up all the numbers. 4, 8 is 12, 12 plus 9 is 21. So I'm taking the total of the third one as T and trying to find the relationship between these three numbers. If I take 18 plus something as 21, that means if I treat these three numbers is as in AP, then this, the value of T should be 21 plus 3, that is 24. Now, if value of t is 24, then 24 is equals to 5 plus 2 is 7 plus 8 is 15 plus the missing number x. In that case, x is equals to 24 minus 15, that is 9. Value of x is 9, the 3 grid total would be in AP option A fits in. Now, one more thing, we can also look at these number like this. If we bipartite, 27 into 2 is 54. If we take this as one number, two digit number, 43 into 2 is 86. That means something into 2 should be equals to 58. That means 58 by 2 is 29. This question mark place, there we should have 29. And there also option A fits in. Okay, before the timer begins, the options are 150, 100, 99 and 125, and the timer starts now. Fair enough puzzle, isn't it? Again, we have done a lot of this, and the basic thing which fits in always is in the column. So here C would be 7 is square. If I do 49, 2 is square is 4. It's simply 49 minus 4. So I can say C is equals B square minus A square. That fit in. Here 11 is square is 121. 1 is square is 1. 121 minus 1 is 20. So our missing number is 10 is square minus 1 is square, 100 minus 1, that is 99. It fits in option C. Okay, the option for 2608 are, option A is 7, 10, 8, and option D is 9, and your time starts now. We are looking out for this missing number. Yes, I guess you must have the answer by now. And the basic dilemma in 3x3 is when all the numbers are of like same capacity. The very first thing which hits in my mind is, let's do the row total and the column total. 6, 5 is 11 and 8 is 19. 8, 7, 15 and 2 is 17. Okay, column total is not same. 5, 8, 13, 6 is 19. 9, 2 and 8 is 19. Okay, these two rows total is same. If I make the second row total also 19, then 7 plus 5 is 12. This missing should be 19 minus 12, that is 7. And yes, that is there in option A. That means 7 fits in at this place. For question number 2609, the option we have are 9, 6, 7, 8, and your timer begins now. sometimes when we keep on searching for the equation which might fit in, it is a simple eye for detailing type of a puzzle which might be offered to us. If we just look at the numbers in each row and combine them to form a number, 121, 121 is 11 is square. Then the next row, all the three digits combined is 144, that is 12 is square. And the last one is 196, that is 14 is square. Then obviously the third row should be 13 is square. Then it will follow the pattern, 11 is square, 12 is square, 13 is square, 14 is square. Now 13 is square is 169, 169. We have 1, we have 6, here we should have 9, and that is in option A. With option for 2610 are 12, 7, 8, 10, and let's solve this. Okay, again the same drill for the one set of puzzle, one block only. Here in the first two columns we have small numbers and in the third column is big number. So 28 divided by 7 will give 4, but this is 3. 100 divided by 20 will give me 5, but this is 4. Bingo. That means 3 plus 1 into 7 is 28. 4 plus 1 into 20 is 100. That means C is equals to A plus 1 into B. If this is A, this is B, and this is C. That means here we are looking out for value A. C is 121, which is equals to A plus 1 into 11, that is B. That means A plus 1 is 11. Value of A is 10. In this place we should have 10, and that is in option D. Okay, one grid with the alphabets. This is Q, let me make this. This is Q, G, I, otherwise it's clear, that is A. Options given are D, B, F, or E. Let's find it. The grid with the alphabets many a time moves row wise or column wise with some forward or move backward with alphabets. Let's check that out. Maybe like that might fit in. I, J, K, L, M, N, O. Okay, this is following the trend of plus one, plus one. W, U, it is moving back. Let me start from the bottom. Q, R, S, T, U, V, W. So from bottom to the top, it's moving. Okay, let me see that in the third column, we have this missing one. In the fourth one, let's see from the bottom if it fits in or not. G H I J K L M, it fits in. That means the third column should be fitting from the top. That is from Y. Y Z A B C D E. At the missing point or at this X vacant space, we should have alphabet E. And this is an alphabet series. Alphabet series ends with A and again it starts with alphabet series ends with Z, C, and again it starts with A. So we can call A as the 27th letter in the alphabetic series, isn't it? So we have followed that. E, alphabet E fits in, that is option D is the answer. So last one of the session, 2, 4, 3, 4, missing, the options are 3, 2, 4, 5, and let me start the timer now. Okay, the smartest and the first format drill in any grid is either multiply, add up, or if doesn't fits in with the number which is larger than these two. Here in column we can see that we have 2, 4, but this number is quite larger than these two. 2 into 4 is 8, which is not fitting in here. So let me mark this as X. So now I'll go for squaring, or if it doesn't fits in with squaring, I'll go for cubing. But let me start by squaring. 2 square is 4. 4 square is 16. But it is not fitting in. Now, but here we can see that 2 plus 4 is 6. And this is 36. That means if this is row 1 is A, row 2 is B, and row 3 is C. Now here we can see that C is equals to A plus B whole square. Isn't it? 3 plus 6 is 9, 9 square is 81, fits in. So for the missing figure in column 2, 49 is equals to 4 plus x whole square, or 4 plus x is 7, because 49 square root is 7, x is equals to 3, that fits in option A. Thank you everyone for participating. These were the actual puzzle asked in Infosys examination, and I thank you all. I'm Mohit Jain signing off from MJ's Maths and Stats, that's MJ Magic Studio to you. Please subscribe to the channel, please, and let it grow if you like our content. There is one more video on puzzles, actual Infosys puzzle. I'll give you the link in the description below. Please also go through it, and best wishes to everyone, those who are writing Infosys hiring, recruitment, online assessment, test, whatever it is. And so, I'll see you soon. Very soon, and best wishes to all. Stay at home, stay safe, and stay fit. Stay connected. Thank you, everyone.